In this video, I'm going to show you how to use your Synology DS920 Plus NAS system to back up your iPhone photos. That way, you can stop paying Apple for their iCloud fee. I'm not saying that Apple iCloud isn't great. I mean, it is great. But as photos build up and as you buy more storage, it just adds up. And I'd rather have control of my photographs in my own hands than have it on Apple's server. Plus, I want to just save a few bucks. Although, in the process, I ended up spending a lot of money for the DS920 Plus. So let's just not go there for now. Let's jump straight into the actual tutorial. Let's go. First step first, navigate to the Apple or Android App Store and look for the Synology Photos app. Once you've got the app, download the app on your phone and fire it up. You'll have to go through some privacy notifications, accept them if you're okay with them, you know what that is. And then use your Synology Quick Connect ID or the local address to log into your NAS account. I blurred this information out for privacy reasons, but you know what you're doing. Put in your Quick Connect ID, your account ID, and click on login. The app will then attempt to log in. After that, allow Photos Mobile to access your local network. I have the two-factor authentication enabled, so I'll need my Synology 2FA code to log into my NAS, but you may not need that based on your settings. Once that's done, you'll be taken onto the login screen. First step, click on Enable Photo Backup. Time to set up the backup parameters. For this example, I'm going to backup all of my photos, so I'll be using Backup All Photos Backup Rule. While default destination is a great idea, I'll be picking up a custom destination to show you how everything works. You are presented with your local directory structure to then select a final backup folder. I'm going to be using a folder called iPhone sitting inside my mobile backup folder. In the upload setting, I'm going to be turning off the Wi-Fi only option, mainly because I have a really good data plan and I want photos to be uploaded as soon as I take them. I'd also like videos to be uploaded, so I'll keep the photos only option turned off and duplicate files to be skipped. On Apple devices, it's now time to grant the app access to all your photos, enable notifications if you'd like to receive them, and once done, it will show me exactly how many photos is backing up. So as you can see on the screen here, it's processing 1,575 items. Click on it for further details. In the backup destination section, it shows customize as I've used a customized folder. Finally, the free up option allows you to delete photos from your iPhone once they have been successfully backed up on the NAS. Here you have the enable sleep time backup option. Sleep time backup keeps the app open but turns off the screen to preserve battery. This allows for quick targeted upload of all your photos and videos. So you can also upload photographs from locations other than the photo gallery. Clicking on the dots up top bring up the upload option. Clicking on upload allows you to pick items you'd like to be uploaded. You also have albums, sharing, and more section at the bottom that allows you to create, share photos, and allow guests to upload photos to your NAS, which is pretty handy. But that's for the next video covering detailed walkthrough of the Photos app. So there you have it. That's how you set up your iPhone to back up all the photos straight to your Synology DS920 Plus. So I'm guessing the process is pretty much the same for other Synology systems. Once you're set up in the way displayed in this video, you'd be able to directly upload all your photos and videos in the background straight to your Synology NAS. That also means you can stop paying Apple for their iCloud subscriptions because it adds up. Anyway, if you enjoyed what I did today, if you like my content, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Also, don't forget to like this video and hit that little bell icon so that next time when I upload a video, you get a notification. And what's next? In my next video, I'll be covering through the actual Synology Photos app in detail. Until then, take care of yourself. Bye.